As we'll hear in the readings today on this fifth Sunday of ordinary time, we're called to be light of the world and salt of the earth. And so our opening hymn is Christ Be Our Light. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Peace be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear friends, my sisters and brothers, let's prepare ourselves by calling to mind our sins and calling to mind God's promise of forgiveness. Kyrie, Kyrie, eleison. Kyrie, Kyrie, eleison. Christe, Christe, eleison. Christe, Christe, eleison. Kyrie, Kyrie, eleison. Kyrie, Kyrie, eleison. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let's celebrate our forgiveness. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to the Father.
Glory to God,
glory to God, glory to the Father, to him be glory forever, to him be glory forever. Alleluia, amen.
Alleluia, amen.
Alleluia, amen. Alleluia,
amen.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to Christ Jesus.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to Christ Jesus.
To him be glory forever,
to him be glory forever.
Alleluia, amen.
Alleluia, amen.
Alleluia, amen.
Alleluia, amen.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to the Spirit.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to the Spirit.
To him be glory forever,
to him be glory forever.
Alleluia, amen.
Alleluia, amen.
Alleluia, amen.
Alleluia, amen.
Let us pray. Father, watch over your family and keep us safe in your care, for all our hope is in you. We ask this for Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The first reading is from the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, share your bread with the hungry, and shelter the homeless poor. Clothe the man you see to be naked, and turn not from your own kin. Then will your light shine like the dawn, and your wound be quickly healed over. Your integrity will go before you, and the glory of the Lord behind you. Cry, and the Lord will answer. Call, and he will say, I am here. If you do away with the yoke, the clenched fist, the wicked word, if you give your bread to the hungry and relief to the oppressed, your light will rise in the darkness and your shadows become like noon. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response to each verse of the psalm is, the good man is a light in the darkness for the upright.
The good man is a light in the darkness for the upright.
He is a light in the darkness for the upright. He is generous, merciful, and just. The good man takes pity and lends. He conducts his affairs with honour.
The good man is a light in the darkness for the upright.
The just man will never waver. He will be remembered forever. He has no fear of evil news. With a firm heart, he trusts in the Lord. The good man is a light in the darkness for the upright. With a steadfast heart, he will not fear. Open-handed, he gives to the poor. His justice stands firm forever. His head will be raised in glory.
The good man is a light in the darkness for the upright.
The second reading is from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. When I came to you, brothers, it was not with any show of oratory or philosophy, simply to tell you what God had guaranteed. During my stay with you, the only knowledge I claimed to have was about Jesus, and only about him as the crucified Christ. Far from relying on any power of my own, I came among you in great fear and trembling. In my speeches and the sermons that I gave, there were none of the arguments that belonged to philosophy, only a demonstration of the power of the Spirit. And I did this so that your faith should not depend on human philosophy, but on the power of God. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us acclaim the gospel.
Alleluia, 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 Alleluia.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "You are the salt of the earth. But if salt becomes tasteless, what can make it salty again? It's good for nothing. It can only be thrown out to be trampled underfoot by men. You're the light of the world. A city built on a hilltop cannot be hidden. No one lights a lamp to put it under a tub. They put it on the lampstand, where it shines for everyone in the house. In the same way, your light must shine in the sight of men, so that seeing your good works, they may give the praise to your Father in heaven." This is the gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Did that seem a bit disjointed and bitty to you? It does to me. You're the salt of the earth. If salt becomes tasteless, what can make it salty again? It's good for nothing. You're the light of the world. Full stop. A city built on a hilltop cannot be hidden. Full stop. No one lights a lamp to put it under a tub. It's likely that these little phrases, disjointed as they are, may well have been said by our Lord on different occasions throughout his public ministry, but they've been so catchy on the ear that people have remembered them. And when it comes to writing the Gospels a generation or two after our Lord's time, all they've got really is scraps and lists of what people have written down. And the Gospel writers have been editing and gathering together, and it seems that these three or four little phrases have been shuffled together to say something similar, to reinforce the point that each of them is making. What is the point? Well, he talks about light, and being the light of the world. And that is an old phrase with the Jews, because it's used in the first reading from Isaiah, 700 odd years before our Lord, to be a light in the darkness. Light in the darkness in ancient times was so precious. We take it for granted. We flick a switch, the light's on. Our streets are lit for the most part. We don't really have to go about at night in mortal fear of falling into a pothole and breaking our legs. Unless you're in certain parts of Liverpool where the potholes are everywhere, practically joined up. But in our Lord's day, this was serious. And so giving light was serious. But light was expensive. Light was made really with olive oil, or if you were incredibly rich, wax. Artificial lights like that are expensive. To make a pathetic little flame from olive oil is the equivalent of what? Having half a pound of best Kerrygold melted in a bowl. You're burning what you could eat the next day. So light and giving it to others costs you. But it's a great service to other people. It's a great charity, a great benefit to put a light by your doorway so people can see. When you have light for yourselves in the family, you probably have just the one flame, the one oil lamp burning. And forget about the paraffin lamps we have these days, just in case there's a power cut. The flame from an oil lamp is pathetic. It's a tiny thing. When you look at the flame that we have here from a candle, that's bright. That's two or three times the size and brightness of an oil lamp flame. So light's rare. It's precious and it's expensive. But our Lord is saying, I want you to be lights to people in the world, in the way you live your lives. And it may cost you. And it might seem a tiny little thing. But that's not the point. If you're having a great celebration, a wedding feast, let's say, think of the wedding feast at Cana. That was the one occasion where you'd pull out all the stops and you'd have hundreds of these little flickering flames. And what seems by itself to be a terrible, pathetic little thing, me, my life, perhaps you, your life. But when they're gathered together, it makes a lovely, wonderful light, a light of celebration, a light where you can see to dance, a light that makes you feel we're having a party. This is what life is all about. All these images are crammed together in this. And although he doesn't mention light, the reading in the second, in the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians, is talking about the witness that this symbol of light is used by our Lord. Because he's not being philosophical. If you were thinking about the deep things in life, in our Lord's day, in Paul's day, why are we here? What's the point of life? Is there a point of life? You would go to philosophy. Philosophy was for the educated. Philosophy was the posh people. Philosophy, first of all, were for those who had the education and the means to have an education and the leisure to think about these deep things. Philosophy was, I've used the phrase before, for your Oxbridge and Cambridge type of person. What Paul says is, I've not used philosophy to bring about the purpose of life, the point of living. All I've done, quite simply, he says, is witness to Christ crucified. And there is the answer to what's the point of life? Why do we go on living? What makes life worthwhile? A simple thing, a relationship with God. That's what he's saying. Nothing that depends upon education or sophisticated thinking, but simply relationship with Christ. And through that comes the witness. And the witness is the light. The witness is the little light that we give. But not a light to be kept to ourselves and only for ourselves. Not a light to be huddled over. That's why the point is about not putting a bucket over your light, but putting it on a lampstand. Not to be ashamed. Not to be keeping your head down. Not to be avoiding attention for the fact that you're a Christian. Or this is why you live your life. Even if it's not fashionable to say it in the world anymore. I'm not talking about walking up and down a high street with sandwich boards on, you know, the end of the world is nigh. But actually, being forthright with people, well, yeah, I'm a believing Christian, I'm a Catholic, and this is why I live like this, and that's why I do that, and don't do the other. This too is witnessing. We've lost the habit, I think, perhaps, of being proud of our faith. Being proud of our relationship with Christ. Not that it's our own property, but it's something wonderful that we have. It's available to everyone that we can attract to it with how we speak, how we do the doings of our lives, how we live. Let us proclaim our faith. I believe in God the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the God the Father Almighty.
and thence you will come to judge the living and the dead.
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy
Catholic Church,
the communion of saints,
forgiveness of sins,
the resurrection of the body,
and life
everlasting. Amen. Let's pray for Pope Francis, that the burdens of age may rest light upon him, that God keeps him healthy, that God eases his aches and pains and stiffness, that God keeps his mind clear and his spirits high. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let's pray for all those in the church burdened with the office of being a bishop, of having to make hard decisions, of having to discern what to do for the best. May the Holy Spirit inspire them and again lift their spirits. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let's pray for all our parishes throughout the diocese and the country and the world as we begin to limp away from the corona years. That new life will come, that spring will break through, and that we may be lights to the world. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let's pray for our sick, those who are sick in body, those who are sick in spirit, those who are sick in their mind, that they'll be restored to health. And that if we can be used as part of their restoration to health, we'll be able to discern when and how to use ourselves and our time for their good. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let's pray for the situation in our country, threatened by strikes of key people in our society, the teachers, health workers, those in public transport on which so many depend, that the situation will be settled with justice and fairness all round. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let's pray for our personal selves, for me and for you, that our lights may shine, small as they may be, so that we too may contribute to the great light in the world that our Lord has promised. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Pray for our dead, that they may rejoice forever in the eternal light of God's presence. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let's ask Our Lady, Queen of Peace, to pray with us and for us. Hail
Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women,
and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
We make these and all our prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Lord God, we ask you to receive us and be pleased with the sacrifice we offer you, with humble and contrite hearts. Lord, wash away my many iniquities. Cleanse me from my sins. Let's pray, my brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Lord our God, may the bread and wine that you give us for our nourishment on earth become the sacrament of our eternal life. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation. Always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, creator of the world and source of all life. For you never forsake the works of your wisdom, but by your providence are even now at work in our midst. With mighty hand and outstretched arm, you led your people Israel through the desert. Now, as your church makes her pilgrim journey in the world, you always accompany her by the power of the Holy Spirit and lead her along the paths of time to the eternal joy of your kingdom through our Lord Jesus Christ. And so, with all the angels and saints, we too praise you as we acclaim with one voice.
Holy, holy, holy,
holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Indeed, you are holy and to be glorified, O God. For you love the human race and always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst when we are gathered by his love. And when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. And so, most loving and holy Father, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine. That they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more he gave you thanks and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Dying, you destroyed our death. Rising, you restored our life.
Lord Jesus, come in glory.
And so, most loving and holy Father, as we celebrate this memorial of Christ your Son, our Saviour, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favour on the offering of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. And so, having called us to a table, Lord, confirm us in unity, so that together with Francis our Pope, Malcolm our Bishop, and all your priestly people, as we walk your ways with faith and hope, we may strive to bring joy and trust into the world. Remember our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever, there in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the apostles and martyrs, with Saint Joseph, Saint Paul of the Cross, and all the saints. We shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son.
Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, Almighty Father, for ever and ever. Amen.
Jesus taught us to call God our Father, and so we have his encouragement to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our day, so that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. You who live and reign for ever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's give each other a sign this peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the
sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you have already come, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Our communion hymn is "Here in This Place, a New Light is Streaming."
Here in this place, a new light is streaming. Now is the darkness vanished away. See in this space, all fears and all dreamings, brought near to you in the light of this day. Gather us in, the lost and forsaken. Gather us in, the blind and the lame. Call to us now, and we shall awaken. We shall arise at the sound of your name. Not in the dark of buildings confining, not in some heaven light years away.
Give us a share in the one bread and the one cup, and make us one in Christ. Help us to bring your salvation and joy to all the world. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless and protect you, now and always. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration is ended. Let's go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our final hymn is "Walk in the Light."
The Spirit.